guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about hair health and things that I've used over the past couple years that have really allowed my hair to stay super healthy. This video is kind of gonna be more of like a serious topic, mood wise, because I just find that it's so important to know your own hair, know what works, and not feel like I don't want this video to be like, buy this. I'm just showing you guys the things that I've used in the last couple of years that have truly helped me, and things that I find so important in my collection. In order to have really healthy hair, you don't have to have a million products. You just need to know how to handle your hair and how to use the products to benefit your hair in the long run. So I'm gonna go over all of that today, and I think that's why I feel like more in a serious mood, because I'm like teaching rather than like, let's do a fun hairstyle. I'm trying to help you guys with your hair problems at home. Not hair problems, but you know what I mean. Okay, let's get right into the video. First off, I wanna say patience, patience. Your hair can't put like a miracle thing on your hair and it just be rejuvenated overnight. I think that there are things that you need to do on a daily basis in order to revitalize the integrity of your hair. First off, I wanna talk shampoo and treatments. I literally use one or two shampoos. I go back and forth, and the ones that I've stuck to for the past 3 years that I use all the time are Olaplex 4, which it's just their shampoo, and then the Aveda Damage Remedy. These two are always in my collection, no matter what, and I love them. One thing I do notice about this one, a little goes a long way, but there's a certain way to get it to go further, if you know what I mean. So usually I just put like a little dime size in the palm of my hands, and I'll rub it a lot with water in my hair, but my hair needs to be completely wet first, and then I kind of move it in there and then wet my hair again really quick and then really lather it up. That's how I get that little dime size to go all over my head. That's the best way it works for me. Sometimes I'll do a tiny bit of purple shampoo in the beginning just to get a tiny bit of lather on my hair, and then put the dime size of this on and then wet it, and then it becomes really lathery and kind of gets all in my hair. I really massage those roots of my head, and then I focus a lot on these front pieces because these front pieces are the most blonde, so they need a lot of attention, and then I'll, you know, wash it out. I honestly don't use a ton of conditioner on my hair. If I do, it's just like right here. Just right here. You know how like a lot of people use hair masks and whatnot? I don't. If anything, I'll use Olaplex 3, but I'll use this treatment like once a month, maybe once every 2 months. I used to use it a lot more than that, but I find that I don't have to anymore. Now, this is not like a conditioning treatment. This is something that you have to do before you wash and condition your hair. So you use this, leave it on for 15 minutes, then go in the shower, shampoo, condition it out. You do not leave this in your hair. This is really good if your hair is like super damaged and you really, really need to rebuild that strength. I would highly suggest you get the number 3 and then follow up with number 4. I really like to just wash my hair once every 3 days. Sometimes I can't, and I have to wash it every other day, and that's fine, but I really try to just let my natural hair oils do their trick. And I find that that has really helped over the years make my hair a lot healthier. Now, when you get out of the shower, I like to take a brush like this, or just a wet brush, and I start at the bottoms, and then I brush my way up, and that's how I get my knots out. I never start up here and then just tug and then brush really, really hard. I always start at the bottom and then work my way up, and that's how I get all the knots out every time I brush my hair. So it's really important. The way that you brush your hair, I feel, is so important, because a lot of people just tug and tug and tug and they don't really use a specific brush. Wet brushes are the way to go. These kinds are my favorite. Now, when it comes to serums, Paul Mitchell Super Skinny Serum, really, really like this stuff. Works great, just adds that really sleek shine that I'm looking for, and then combats a lot of frizz, which I absolutely love, and it is humidity resistant. I live in the South, so you know that there is humidity here, and my hair hardly ever gets frizzy, which is very nice. Also, heat protectant. I really, really like this one. This one's from Croc. This is the Multiflex, and I just spray a couple spritzes on my hair. It's a very lightweight heat protectant, but I use this before I blow dry or flat iron. I think that this flat iron is probably the most important thing that I have in my collection. Croc has amazing technology when it comes to heat distribution. They have the black titanium plates, which allows heat to really evenly distribute, and therefore you can use a lot less heat on your hair, and it works really well. They also have an infrared technology on this flat iron and on some of their flat irons where it just allows you to use a lot less heat, and it like puts the heat at a higher frequency, so it penetrates the hair a lot quicker, so you don't need to use as much heat and you don't need to like go over your hair so many times. I found that with other flat irons, I'm constantly like going over again, and then going over that end piece just to make sure it's really, really straight. With this one, I'll literally use 320 to 350. 350 is like on a stubborn day, but 320 is what I normally use on my flat irons. I turn the infrared on and I'm good to go. I can straighten, I can curl my hair, I can do whatever with 320. So you do not need to use, what does this go up to? This goes up to 450. You don't need to use 450 on your hair. Obviously, some people's hair is, some are more coarse than others. You can use higher heat on coarser hair. Finer hair, you can use a lot lower heat. So the lowest heat that you can go, the better. And this has really, really helped keep the damage down, because the least amount of heat that you can do, the better. You know what I mean? So this is my ride or die. You guys know I've been talking about it for years, but I just find it's really, really, really important. Link it down below, and you can use code CHLOE30 to get money off of that. Same with this too, so you can bundle these together. They also have a curling iron on there, which has the black titanium plates, or the black titanium barrel. Works great too, and I use 370 Fahrenheit on that. Works like a charm, never fries my hair. If you're using your flat iron and you find that you're hearing sizzling, you're not using the right products, or your flat iron is just way too hot. If there's steam coming off of your flat iron, that's not good. Like, that is just taking the moisture out of your hair. And if you find that your hair, you're going over these front pieces or any type of whatever on your hair, and it looks like straw, you know what I mean? Like just crinkled straw, it's too high. Do not do that. Don't do that. You will ruin your hair, and you're just gonna have to wait for it all to grow back out again. Okay, now when it comes to hairsprays, I really like two brands of hairsprays, maybe three that I've tried, and I've tried a lot. I've tried a lot. And the one that I keep going back to are the Aveda ones. I find that they're very easy to wash out of my hair. They don't create buildup, they're naturally derived, and they work great. I really like the Control Force. It's a medium hold hairspray. Love it, especially for teasing, holding that tease, and then I'll just spray it all over my head really, really quickly, like this. And then I'm done, and I just find that it has the perfect amount of hold for my hair. I really like the Air Control too. The last time I went to Aveda to go pick up these, they were out. I should probably order it online, but the Air Control is my absolute favorite. That is a lighter hold hairspray, works great. Another hairspray that I really, really like is the, I ran out of it as well, the Healthy Sexy Hair hairspray. So touchable, that's what it's called. I'll link it down below. Really like that hairspray. I just really like light hairsprays. I think that you can build up on those. There's ways that you can curl your hair to allow it to stay a couple days without continuously having to refix curls and whatnot. I find that the heat is the most damaging to the hair, and going over it and over it and over it and brushing and brushing and brushing it. That is what breaks off hair so much. One thing that I would highly suggest is not to spray hairspray on your hair before you straighten it or curl it. Those are only for special occasions. You don't want to do that all the time. No, don't do it. So if your hair does not hold a curl very well, I don't suggest for you to hairspray it and then curl it. If you need to, do like a dry texture spray on it before you curl it. Whenever I style my hair, I try to just keep it the way that it's styled for 3 days. So I will style it the first day, keep it the second day, and then the third day. And if it looks bad or if it looks greasy, I'll put it up. Or I've been loving headbands lately and it covers up the grease great. Like today is day 3 here and it looks fine. And then I'll wash it tonight and we'll start all over. Now the dry shampoo that I love, I like the Aveda Shampoo. And then I also like Hair Laundry by Sexy Hair. I don't like the spray ones. I really don't. I find that they look very chalky on the hair and you can't like rub it in as good. So these I really like because this one's a pump and it's just, I don't know, it's actual like just powder and then you can rub it in. This one's the same thing, it's just a squeeze bottle. So it's just like that and then you can rub it in. Whereas I find that those spray ones, I don't know if it's the aerosol in them or what, but they kind of leave a haze. Haze is the word, like a chalky haze. I'm not a huge fan of that. So I prefer the powder ones. I like the feel of them better. And I find that they're easier to wash out because they don't like stick to your hair. They're just like powder that's rubbed in. So if you're wearing your hair in a ponytail, just know your hair is gonna fall out more. There's just something about, you know, tugging a rubber band around your ponytail that really just pulls your hair out, and that's okay. It's gonna happen. But if you have damaged hair, try not to use like the elastics as much. And if you do, make sure they're the really shiny ones that just like you can take out of your hair really easily. You don't want these, you know, all over your head. I use these when I wear my hair half up, half down. Some hair does fall out. It's just the name of the game. Just be a little bit careful. You can also use like a little face razor and just cut them out rather than pulling out. It's better to cut them out than pull them out. Yeah, those are the things that I've used. Like I said, there's not a lot of products, like hardly at all, that I've used to just really keep my hair healthy and to cause minimal damage. If I do curl my hair, you guys notice most of the time I straighten the ends, and I find that that has really, really helped not putting the curling iron at the end of my hair. Like, you know, when you just have it sitting there on the heat, because I do use a higher heat if I use a curling iron. I use about like 360 to 370 if I use a curling iron. And so that's hotter heat on the bottom. Using the straightener on the bottom instead with that infrared has just allowed my ends to stay a lot healthier. If you go and get your hair colored, like if you go get your hair bleached and you have like previous hair history, and what I mean by previous hair history is if you choose to be brown and then you go blonde on top of that, and then you go brown again and then blonde on top of that, the bleach and the brown is never coming off and it's very hard to penetrate through what's already been processed. That's why when I go, I just get my roots just touched up. I never touch these ends. So what's ever blonde before is as light as it's gonna be. And I'm just, if I don't want it anymore, then I just grow it out. I don't ever like dye over it. Obviously that's unavoidable if you really want a hair change, but if you do really want the health of your hair to be really good, try to keep your dye options low. Don't try to just like color brown over it because you don't like the blonde, and then color blonde right over what you just colored brown, because that's really gonna kill your hair because you're bleaching over the same part twice. You don't wanna do that. So try to limit the bleach as much as possible. Your hair professional should be able to tell you exactly what you need to do when it comes to bleaching your hair, and they should be able to go over with you that hair history. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that it was very informative to you. If you need any help, go ahead and DM me on Instagram. I try to answer every single one of my DMs. It might take me a couple weeks, but I promise you I will get back to you, or you can go ahead and put a comment down below. And everything that I've talked about in this video will be linked in the description box below, and coupon code Chloe30 for the Croc items. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.